And what did the mission to kill Osama bin Laden do to the relationship?
Initially it severely undermined it because it showed several things. One is it showed the, from the Pakistan standpoint, it showed how little the U.S. actually trusted Pakistan. From the American standpoint, it also showed, in a sense, how the U.S. could not trust Pakistan, that he was so deep in Pakistan territory.
So back to 2004 to 2008, what happened to al-Qaeda during that period?
Well, that's a great question. This is what we call the second wave.
Right.
And the second wave really begins around the time of the U.S. invasion of Iraq. What al-Qaeda is able to do that it did not have is establish a foothold after the invasion, led by, about December 2004, al-Qaeda really gets an affiliate.
Right.
Abu Musab al-Zarqawi pledges allegiance to bin Laden. And we see a major increase in attacks by al-Qaeda in Iraq. And then we see in 2004, we see the Madrid attacks done to get the Spanish government to pull its forces out of, not just anywhere, but out of Iraq. Mm-hmm. And then we see in 2005, we see Mohammad Siddiqui Khan and a range of four individual Pakistani British conduct the attacks in London. So we're getting a surge in activity, and a lot of the radicalization happens because of the war in Iraq.
Join us online at charlierose.com.